Hi, welcome to Unlock Layout and Design, and today we'll discuss an effect known as the well proximity effect in anvil fabrication. So I want to form the anvil like this, and I use a technique known as the ion implantation. So when I do this ion implantation, very high energy beam, ion beam, is actually focused in the exposed area. See, here you have the photoresist, okay, and the oxide, and in between is the exposed area. So I focus a very high energy ion implant beam in this region. So what happens is, when this beam hits this photoresist, this area, this photoresist, what happens is they will get diverted like this, as shown in this diagram, and also in this diagram they get diverted. And then what happens is, in the end, in the ends of the anvil, in the ends of this anvil, in this region and this region, there won't be a uniform doping density. There won't be a uniform doping density in the corners of the well or on the edges of the well. Okay, so this gives rise to a gradient. Okay, there is a gradient now, means the doping density here and doping density here and in the middle, they won't be the same. So this gives rise to an effect known as the well proximity effect. So if you see in this diagram, this is the well edge. Okay, well edge as written here, this is the well edge, and transistors can be placed at different distances from the edge of the well. So this is the well spacing, WSPC is the well spacing. If you consider this device, it is placed very much away from the well, and well spacing is around 25 micrometer, whereas this transistor here, it is close, very close to the anvil edge. So now these two devices will not behave the same, because there is a well gradient. Okay, we saw that one. In the edges, the doping density is higher, whereas in the center, the doping density is normal. Okay, similarly, you can see here also, this is the anvil. One transistor is sitting very close to the edge, and this transistor is not, these two transistors are not sitting at the edge, whereas this transistor has got edge both sides. Okay, so now this one, what do you mean by well proximity effect? Means how, P means proximity, proximity means very close to the well edge. So whenever these transistors are very close to the well edge, they experience what is known as the well proximity effect. They will have an effect which we will see in the next slide. So the transistors that are placed very close to the anvil edge, suppose this is the anvil, I place a transistor very close to the edge, they will see some effects. So those are nothing but the threshold voltage will get varied, the body effect coefficient will change, and the carrier mobility will also change. But among all these three, the most important one is the threshold voltage variation. Okay, so this threshold voltage of the devices which are placed very close to the well will be different than the ones which are present away from the well. So if you see this diagram, this is nothing but the well spacing. Okay, so now I have, this is 1 micrometer, 2 micrometer from the well edge. Okay, when I keep placing devices away from the well edge, then the threshold voltage will vary. So if you see, the nominal threshold voltage of the device is around 670 millivolt. 0.67 means 670 millivolt. So here 670 millivolt. So devices which are placed from, like say, 3 micrometer and away from the well proximity, well edge, they have like almost constant 670 millivolt of threshold voltage. And the devices that are placed very close to the well edge, say 1 micrometer and 2 micrometer, distance from the well edge in this region, they have a increased threshold voltage. So instead of 670, see the threshold voltage will increase. The one which is very close to the well edge will have something as close to like 730 millivolt. So from 670 it became 730 millivolt, which is roughly around 60 millivolt of difference, as high as 60 millivolt of difference for 670 millivolt. That is roughly like 10%, close to 10%. So let's try to understand again. So this portion is like away from the well. So any device that is placed from the well from 3 micrometer and above will not see the well proximity effect. Its threshold voltage will be around 670 millivolt. But as and when you move the device very close to the well edge, it will have a increased threshold voltage. So threshold voltage increases. Same thing is depicted here also. So if you see, this is the well 1 micrometer distance from the well edge, and if it is like less than that, you see an increase in threshold voltage by around 30 millivolt. So this is a practical number. Around 30 millivolt of threshold voltage variation would be there if the devices are very close to the well. Okay, so this is the important effect, which is a well proximity effect. Proximity means very near to the well edge. Okay, there is something known as the S oriented device and D oriented device. What do you mean by that? So now this is the N well, okay, and we have the corners of the N well, the edges of the N well, they have different density, and the devices put very close to the edge will have well proximity effect. Okay, so but now I have here a device for which the source is very close to the well edge. In this device the source is closest to the well proximity effect, whereas in this device I have the drain which is experiencing a very high well proximity effect. So will this matter? Anyway, both the devices threshold voltage will increase. Okay, for both the devices the threshold voltage will increase, but for a source oriented device the threshold voltage will be different, increase would be different, the percentage increase would be different than the drain oriented device. If you see here, this is the one, this portion of the diagram is what you have to focus on. And if you see in this one, this is the current this is the difference between like the source oriented and the drain oriented, which should be around 8% difference between them only. Among them only there will be a difference. Okay, so if it is a source, it will be like the current carrying capacity would be higher, drain it would be little lesser. Both are having WPE effect, but drain is experiencing more here, source is experiencing more here, means towards the source. So let's see what is the effect on current mirrors because of this well proximity effect. Suppose say I have a current mirror like this. Okay, so let me draw a current mirror like this. This is VDD, and say this is say 10 microamp. So here also it should mirror a 10 microamp. So now this device is the device which is very close to the well. This device is in the center and it is not close to the well edge. Okay, you can see the same thing here. This is B and this is A. Now we will do some simple calculation here. Okay, in order to understand the quantitatively how much difference would be there. So we know I have assumed mu P COx to be 50 microamp per volt square, and threshold voltage around 500 millivolt. Current equation in saturation, we all know it is half mu n mu p COx W by L VGS minus VT whole square. So for this I have substituted the values, and W by L, W is say 10 micrometer, and L is 1 micrometer. So W by L will be 10, and 700 millivolt is the threshold voltage VGS that I have applied, and VTH is 500. So this one will be around 0.2 volt. When I square this one, it will become 0.04, and if I calculate the current that way, it will be 10 micro. As we have seen here, it will be 10 micro. Whereas when this mirror happens, the VGS for both the transistors, it is same. Okay, the VGS is still same, but VT has varied here because of the well proximity effect. In this one, VT was 500 for this device. For this device, VT has changed. VT has become, instead of 500, it has increased to 530 millivolt. So now it will introduce what is known as the systematic error or systematic mismatch. Okay. So this actually is in our hand, right? If I place it away from the well, I don't have the well proximity error. But I have done this layout in such a way that this transistor A has gone very close to the well edge. Because of that, I introduced a well proximity error of 30 millivolt in the threshold voltage. Because of that, if I calculate the ID now, instead of 10 micro, it is mirroring only 7.225 micro. microamps. Okay, so it is giving only 7.225 microamp, and the error is 2.775 micro, or it is around 27% of error. Okay, so now this is not correct. We should not do it like this. Okay, so this is the error that it will introduce because of the systematic mismatch introduced by the well proximity. Yeah, so this is one more example of current mirror. So wherein the current mirror, the diode connected device, this is known as the diode connected device. Okay, so this is known as the diode connected device, meaning, so this is the current mirror. So this is the current mirror, which is a diode connected. So that is the device which you see here. And this is the other device, which is mirroring. So now what happens is, this guy is passing a 10 microamp current. Okay. So it has got some VGS. Say VGS is some 700 millivolt, and VTH is say 530 millivolt. Okay, but the same VGS is there for this device also. VGS is same 700 millivolt, because the source and this is the source of both the devices, which is same, and gate is also the same. So VGS is same, but VT has changed. VT for this guy is only 500 millivolt. So in ID is half mu p cox w by l into VGS minus VTH whole square. So in this second case, in this transistor, the VT is less. So VGS minus VT will be higher, and therefore the current will be much higher, because this is a square term. Okay, it will be much higher. So if this is 10 micro, here I can expect some 12.5 micro. So here I introduced a mismatch which is increasing. Okay, so this kind of effects can come in current mirrors based on like where you place the devices. Okay, so in the earlier case, what happened is, so I had placed the diode connected device here like this, right? Okay, so this became the diode connected device, and this is the mirroring device. So here what happened, so this one had got the lesser threshold, this one had the higher threshold, that's why the current here was less. So in this case, it's just opposite. So this guy, has the higher VTH and this guy has got the lesser VTH. So therefore it will mirror higher current. Hope this is clear. So now we have to discuss how to decrease the well proximity error or how to prevent the devices from having the well proximity effect. Okay. So for that, what we should do is from the well edge, we will keep the devices away. Okay. So this is the minimum distance I will keep from the well edge so that I can have a very little well proximity effect. Then what I also do is to put a dummy here. Okay. I put a dummy device both sides. Okay. So these are the transistors of interest, which are actually my circuit devices, which will actually mirror the current or do something else. So I will put them in the center, way away from the well edge. So it's at a very good distance from the well edge now. So I can protect my devices from well proximity effect. So this is in the hand of layout engineer. If he does a mistake, he will introduce something known as the systematic offset. Mismatch. So the layout engineer would be introducing a systematic mismatch by doing a wrong layout because of well proximity effect. So one more thing which is in, so these two we discussed. There is one more effect. One more way to prevent well proximity effect, that is by increasing the VGS of the device, current mirror devices, but that is in the hand of designer. If you see here, this portion, I don't see a big variation in the threshold voltage for this portion because VGS is higher. Whereas when VGS is lower, I can see a big difference in the devices. So thanks for watching, and in this video we have discussed about well proximity effect and how to prevent them. So if you like the video, please hit the like button and don't forget to share and subscribe. Thank you.